Hey y'all, what's up everybody? This is your girl T.S. Madison, honey. Listen, I know I've been talking about somebody want to lose weight, but I ain't gonna never lose no motherfucking weight with Holly cooking ass coming around here. Holly been feeding me every day, y'all. Holly came and brought me, 2 days ago, Holly came and brought me some
gumbo.
Today she's come here and bringing me some damn
Roasted chicken.
Jerk chicken.
Salmon croquettes.
And macaroni and cheese.
Macaroni cheese and peas and rice. It's hot.
I wish you would have made some yams.
You know, I should have made some, but I had clients today, so I just kind of piggybacked off of it.
Hey, Ty. Look, y'all. Holly's sitting over there in her bonnet.
I just got my hair done. Today's my birthday.
Today is Holly's birthday. Y'all wish Holly a happy birthday. Wish her a happy birthday.
I'm 43 today.
She 43. I'm 42, girl. Welcome to the 40 club. Yes, Holly.
I'm excited. We're going out tonight, so.
Oh, honey. She's going out for a little while, and then she's coming back home, honey. So, scoot around here, Holly. So you can tell. Scoot the chair right here. So I got to be trying. You can be in here with me. So, girl, I got this head wrap on, girl.
But she looks really pretty. Really pretty.
I got my head wrap on, bro. You know what I'm saying?
She looks really, really cute.
Yes, I'm still looking like last night here. You see it.
Oh.
It's my birthday, too.
Ooh.
Yeah.
Hawaiian Silky.
This is some youth beauty. This hair came from, this is a youth beauty, some 30 inch. This
that
is 30,
nice.
30 inches of mane, girl.
I'm gonna pull my
30 inches of mane, girl, honey. You know what I'm saying? Giving you aunties, girl.
Yes.
You know, very, very little Kim. Hey, Jerome. Giving you very little Kim tees, girl. You know.
You look good.
So tell the people what you made for me.
Okay, so we got four cheese mac and cheese.
Mm-hmm.
We have salmon croquettes. You love that roasted chicken.
I do.
And then you have the jerk chicken that's grilled. And you have the peas and rice that's a little lime.
What made you? So is it from your heritage that you make a salmon croquette with?
You know, just from working in southern restaurants. Like in the South, everybody does a salmon croquette, but they use the canned salmon. I don't use this canned salmon. I buy fresh salmon and do a fresh salmon croquette. It's a little spicy because that jerk sauce got on.
No, this salmon croquette is really, it's really good.
It's made with fresh salmon. It's not that canned salmon. You know how people make salmon croquettes with the salmon? You know, I actually buy a flat of half a salmon and I cook it and then I make it like, make it that way. The experience is just so much better. So much better.
And I appreciate this so much better. It is so tasty.
When we do your drop offs, we can do those. For you, the little lemon basil aioli with that, or just a little lemon period would be really good with it.
You can make me this with some grit, but see you. Okay, Holly's getting ready to start me on
a healthy eating plan, which is high protein and low carb. So we can't have grits with it.
Well, at least the first time.
But we can do that. We can do that with a lot of vegetables.
What about plantains? Can I have plantains?
I mean, they're fried. I can bake them for you, but they're still very sweet. We can incorporate them in there, you know, just a little bit, just to give you a little, you know, a little something.
Oh, Oliver is texting me. He said, "You bitch, you saved me a plate. You brought me food though."
Oliver gonna be with me on Wednesday. I'm feeding Oliver on Wednesday, so I'll
Also, Oliver, you weren't gonna tell me that you were gonna be with Holly on Wednesday.
Eight folks coming through.
Oh.
Yes, so Oliver having roasted barbecue chicken, macaroni and cheese. I haven't figured out their vegetable yet, and then they're having crab cakes.
I'm finished telling me what Oliver's doing this week. I didn't know what Oliver's doing this week.
Crab cakes for their appetizer with his seasoning, the seasoning that me and him came up with. His seafood seasoning? you didn't know all that.
Is it a butter?
No, it's not a butter, but it can't be put into a butter. So, yeah. And then I might do collard green spring rolls, too, for Oliver then. So, but yeah, Oliver will be on Wednesday.
So, that means Wednesday, what I was expecting for us to be done won't be completed until...
Oh, it's gonna be early though. They're coming to me early.
Thank you.
Oliver, I'm sorry.
Thank you, Holly.
I don't tell it on Oliver.
Holly, thank you.
To the world. Oliver, I'm sorry.
Thanks, Holly.
I'm sorry, Oliver.
You always got to keep a good girl in your pocket. That's gonna pour the real tea. So,
oh, Jesus.
Holly, you fix me a big ass plate, girl.
Yeah, that's a half a chicken.
I don't want to eat no half a chicken.
Yeah, but it's good. Don't
but I want to eat this right here.
It's really good.
This is the part I want. I just want to eat this part right here.
It's so juicy.
This the roasted rosemary
that's
chicken.
That's the roasted rosemary chicken. And it's juicy. It's so juicy. Nobody has chicken like mine because nobody has the brine that I have. I made it up on my own. It's not the regular brine that you see online. Mine is completely different. So it makes your chicken juicy. You can reheat your chicken. Because we reheated this basically. You know what I'm saying?
Ooh.
And it's still juicy. And that's the breast.
I
when do you get juicy breast?
Whoa.
Well, yeah, I know. Right here.
Well.
Bam.
Well.
And we'll, you can do that all day long.
So you can, so on my eating plan, because Holly's getting ready to do me an eating plan. Mm-hmm.
Yeah, we can do roasted chicken all the time, but we'll just do the breast part.
Yeah, please no dark meat.
Yeah, we'll just do the breast part.
Only time I like dark meat is on my dicks.
Me too.
That's the only time I love dark meat, when it's on my dicks. My dicks have to be dark meat. Bitch.
Okay.
But I said, when I
you
like, when
preference.
I, my preference for my dicks has to be the darkest meat.
Okay, okay, I got you. I got you. Black and berry.
It has to be dark meat.
Sweet
of
the juice.
It just, there's a flavor on a dark meat that's on a dick.
That you can't find nowhere else, huh? Okay. From your mouth to God's ears.
And from his pants to my mouth. Oh, girl. I'm just saying. Ain't no shame in my motherfucking game.
Oh, my goodness.
Bitch. Dark meat.
As long as it ain't too big, it'll get scary.
Girl, please. The bigger the
that,
meat,
that, that's
the darker it should be.
If it's really, really big, I'm like, uh-uh. Nope. Nope. That's scary.
Holly.
Try to mash up your guts.
Mash up my guts.
Yeah, or something big like that.
And then he can yammin.
Well,
so you like yammin.
Yep, like
and then mash up your
don't
guts.
Don't mash up my guts.
No mash up your guts?
Don't mash up my guts.
No mash up your guts?
Because then you be farting and shit and all that because your guts mash up.
Well, I'm going to fart anyway because he ain't got but one place to go.
So you like your food, right?
Everybody I love my food.
Okay, good. You got extras.
Oh, I ain't know Oliver was doing all of these things because I be looking out for my daughter.
Is he, what did he say? Did he say something? Oh.
He stopped texting me because he's busted.
Oh. I am so sorry, Oliver.
It's okay. I got to keep my informant on my own day.
You got to tell me. You got to tell me when to shut up, Oliver.
So, this is grill.
That's grill, yes. And that's the jerk.
I like the jerk chicken, but I'm in love with the roasted chicken. So, this will be a part of my meal plan
yes,
when you
do
it.
Yes, we can do that. We can do salads with this, with the jerk.
So.
But that's thighs, so I'll make sure that I do breast for you.
Mm-hmm. Yeah. I like the jerk.
Since I know that your preference is breast meat.
I like the jerk, but I'm more in love with.
The roasted.
Mm-hmm. 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 You know I love the macaroni.
Yeah, I know. But you can't have that.
No, I can't have the macaroni, so I'm out.
That
a part of my meal plans, would you be able to make me roasted chicken?
Mm-hmm.
Obviously, I can't have much rice.
No. I'm not going to probably give you hardly any rice. Hardly any. We'll do salmon croquettes. We'll do roasted
girl,
chicken.
Girl, I don't want to always be eating salmon.
You know, I was going to be eating salmon. We're going to do crab cakes. Because those are actually really light in calories. And
but that's breaded.
I don't have to put that much filler in it. I don't have to put that much filling in. My crab cakes. You've had my crab cakes before.
Yes.
Yeah.
So you basically gonna do those Baltimore crab cakes.
Right. Those.
You know those
Baltimore. Yeah.
Let me tell you something. Oops. Those Baltimore crab cakes.
Yum.
Those girls are all meat.
Mm-hmm.
Light bread.
Mm-hmm.
So they like dark meat too.
Right.
In Baltimore.
Well, no, yeah, we didn't. Those you bake them. You know what I mean? So that's even better for you. You know.
So you bake this?
No, this one was fried. This one was fried.
This is so good. Yeah, is there fried. Extra of these?
No, there isn't. Oh, wait a minute. No, you have one more. You do. You got one more. It's a fat one, too.
Okay.
Yeah, long it's a fat one. It's a fat one. You do. You have one more left.
Here. This is so good.
You have
jerk
chicken and then you have that. You don't have any more roasted chicken. But I'm sure Oliver, we can send her roasted chicken on Wednesday, right? Mm.
So how do I, okay, what I want you to do, Holly, for me is like when we get ready to like really do this in January, mm-hmm. I know we said on this, mm-hmm. so I'm going to do rosemary chicken. Mm-hmm.
But we can't do it every day because you get tired of it.
But I could eat bird every day.
Cork.
Cork. Every day.
Want some cork.
So we do rosemary chicken. Uh-huh. So it will be more vegetables.
It'll be more vegetables, a lot more vegetables, a lot of asparagus. Because, you know, vegetables don't have a lot of calories in them, and they digest so quickly and well. And we don't need to be eating after 5 o'clock. We need this food to digest. This is going to be the crazy thing. A lot of people are probably going to give me a lot of crap about this. I need you to go to bed semi-hungry.
Why? So because I can get up in the morning?
Your body's going to burn a lot of fat at night when you're like that. I hate, a lot of people are going to give me a, probably eat me up about that one. But I'm telling you, when you go to bed, like...
So that means I can't eat after 5?
I don't want you to eat after 5. You see how much weight I've lost? Mm-hmm. Okay. Don't eat after 5. Get your water. Get you, like, some pickles. Stuff like that that, you know, if you don't have an issue with salt, get something, even cucumbers. Just get some cucumbers and eat that at night if you're hungry. You know what I mean? Because you don't want your body working too hard when you sleep. And trust me, it's going to fall off of you faster.
So what if I had avocado and tomato?
I wouldn't do it. Oh, tomato.
No, but sure. No avocado.
I wouldn't do the avocado at night. I say do cucumbers. Do like celery sticks, cucumbers, carrots, stuff like that, you know, if you're hungry late at night. Don't give your body too much work. Because, you know, when you rest and you have too much food in your stomach, you gain weight. Mm. You know, you want your body to be...
Oh, my God.
You want your body not to have too much to do while you're sleeping so it can burn fat for energy while you sleep.
Oh, my God. I'm going to bust this.
Y'all up. Don't eat me up about this. I'm just saying what works for me. I'm not saying I ain't no doctor. Or nothing like that. I'm just saying what works for me.
I like the jerk chicken, but I'm really enjoying this.
It's roasted. Mm-hmm. You said you liked it roasted, though. You said you liked it roasted. But I just wanted to bring you, like, a, you know, a full amount of food.
Okay.
Food.
So, when I put in the order, roasted chicken. Mm-hmm.
It's going to have less filler in it when we do the salmon croquette. So, it won't have as much breadcrumbs. The breadcrumbs hold it together, but that's okay. We're going to bake them. We're not going to.
But the breadcrumbs taste so good.
I know. And they're those Italian breadcrumbs, so they have a little flavor to them. But we're not going to use as much. And we're going to bake yours. We're not going to fry yours.
How did this taste like a comfritter?
Almost, right?
It tastes like a comfritter.
Yep, almost.
It put me in the mind of Miami.
My comfritters are bomb. I use beer when I make my comfritters.
Listen, this put me in the mind of Miami and the Goon Bay. Goon Bay, you don't know the Goon Bay? The festival, the Goon Bay festival? No, oh, you're not from Miami.
I'm not from Miami. I only used to go up there, you know, once a year to go to conventions, and that's it.
Bro, that salmon croquette was like a comforter.
I'm glad you like it. But we can definitely incorporate salmon croquettes, crab cakes in for you. You can even do like some lamb and stuff.
I don't like lamb.
You don't like lamb? Okay, so can't do lamb.
Maybe because I've never had lamb prepared correctly for me.
I'm going to make you some lamb. I'm going to make you some, not lamb chops, but eventually I'll make you some lamb chops. But I'm going to make you like some braised lamb shanks. You'll like that. If you like oxtail, you like lamb. You'll like braised lamb shanks. It's cooked very similar, except I braised it in red wine. It's delicious.
I don't know what it is about lamb. And
it's got a gamey taste. It tastes like it was shot outside and then drug it in and threw it on the back of your truck.
I don't like lamb. Yeah, I'm not a lamb girl.
It's gamey, but I love it. We can do shrimp.
I'm a shrimp girl.
Yeah, we can do shrimp. And it's a lot. Because shrimp and stuff don't have a lot of calories if you prepare it right. Now, you know, we put all that butter and stuff on it, then, you know, and that's how we like it. But you can't have it. Crab legs. Crab legs are very low in calorie, but it's all that butter that you incorporate, you know.
Well, Greta, if you're taking away the butter, how are you going to eat the goddamn shit?
Well, we're going to figure something out. We'll probably make some type of Creole sauce and make it primarily chicken broth based. And add just a little bit of butter. We'll try it. We're going to figure it out. But for the most part, we know what we're going to start off. We're going to have roasted chicken. And we're gonna have croquettes and we're gonna have crab cakes, and we'll start off there and then we'll progress from there. And then we gotta come up with like a real low calorie salad dressing.
That's gonna be some time. What is a low calorie salad?
I mean, like, I'm gonna have to use, I can't use sugar in it. We're gonna have to use something that's more like Italian vinaigrette kind of based. Which, I don't know, do you even like Italian vinaigrette?
If it has some sugar in
it. Right, right. So, see, well, you know, Splenda makes this, like, this new type of brown, like, sugar that's, like, reduced. I might can play with that a little bit, but that's going to take some time because that's something I got to really.
But Splenda mess with your brain.
It does?
That's what I heard.
Really? I didn't know that.
I heard that Splenda sugar mess with your brain.
I don't know that.
Holly, it's not that I don't like this chicken.
You don't like dark meat.
No, this chicken is good. But this so good. That I just wanted to savor this flavor in my mouth.
You have the my cock in your mouth. Oh, Well, we'll do more roasted chicken. I should have done more because I had more. I should have done more. I just did that one.
Just all the roasted chicken left?
I only did one.
Oh, I will be saving this.
Okay. I didn't know. Well, Wednesday I can bring you some
Oliver's party.
I put more than enough on Brian for Oliver's party. So
for Oliver's party.
So I'll bring you. Let me see if he texted me. I ain't getting in trouble.
He ain't in trouble. He have his life to live.
I'm good. He
ain't texting me. Oh. What about Cornish hens?
You know, Cornish hens are just like baby chickens. So, yeah, we can do those, too.
Because I like Cornish hens.
Mm-hmm. It's the same thing. We can do those, too. Mm-hmm. Actually, I'm doing a wedding. And
they're doing half
Cornish hens.
Mm-hmm. Half Cornish hens?
It's plated. They have half Cornish hens on their plate. It's really cute. Really cute. Well, you gave that bone the business, huh?
I wanted to really suck it some more, but then it would look lewd and lascivious on Instagram. That's why I laid it over here to the side. So that when the video's finished.
It'll be sucking at off camera, right? Mm-hmm.
But this is the last of the roasted chicken?
That's the last of the roasted chicken. But you'll have more on Wednesday.
Yeah, but I do need you to plate this because I know your rule about eating after 5. Yeah, but I will be having this after 5 o'clock. Because I'm not on that meal plan yet.
No, you're not on meal plan yet. So you can fuck up all the...
So what do you want? When do you want to start it? January what?
Let's say the third week in January. Just because the first week in January, I'm kind of busy because a lot of people... Okay, we're going to the second week?
Yes.
Okay, the second week. A lot of people are coming at me because a lot of people get engaged during the holidays. Everybody somehow gets excited and they all get engaged during the holidays. And so then I get real busy as far as meeting with clients to plan their weddings. So we can start the second week. Start you don't like that little part right there?
Mm-mm.
Oh, my God. Ooh, I messed them up.
You from the island.
I sure am.
And y'all suck this up.
I sure do. The hot sauce.
This little part right here.
I love that little part.
What you do to that? Like, how you eat it?
I just suck on it until all the meat come off of it. Ooh. I just thought about what I said.
Gentlemen.
Oh my God.
Holly stuffs until all the meat comes off.
Oh my goodness. But I like it, you know. There's no other way to say it. That's what I do. I suck until all the meat comes off.
Holly, I really don't want to eat this.
Eat it, Madison. I'm gonna bring you more on Wednesday. And then for Christmas. I can do you a turkey. I can brine you a whole turkey.
I'm going to be in Miami.
Oh, yeah. You're not going to be here.
That's but right. You can give me some when I come back. I can have a welcome back Christmas.
Yes, we can do that. We can do a spatchcock turkey for you.
What kind of cock turkey?
Spatchcock. Like we're going to split it so that the breast sticks up and its legs are open. I really got to stop talking.
It's a spatchcock.
You cut the backbone out and it just kind of lays flat. Everything is just open. Don't worry about it. You'll see it. You'll like it. You'll
a spatchcock. Spatchcock.
It's the way you cut it. Yeah. The way you cut it. You cut it so that it opens like this.
Right. Like a woman with no backbone.
Pretty much.
ready to be plowed.
Ready. Boobs in the air. Literally, like the breast is in the air and the legs is wide open. Damn. Did I screw that up? Spatchcock.
So, Holly, where did you learn how to cook?
I went to, okay, well, I always knew how to cook. And if truth be told, I started learning how to cook years ago with my daughter's grandmother in North Carolina. And I was really, really young. And then I got married. I married an African guy. And them African women. They got me in the kitchen. They taught me like the base of like seasoning food and how to make things. Like they took me back to like the roots
of seasoning food.
Right.
So it's safe to say that the root of seasoning food originated in Africa.
I would say for me, yes. They taught me so much. Well, actually, she was really one lady. She taught me so much, and then I just became really good at it. I started like watching TV shows and, you know, cookbooks and stuff like that. And then I had an opportunity to either go to law school, get a master's.
So we're going to say it again for the people that are out there. The basis to seasoning meats and foods, you would say,
originated in Africa. West Africa.
Yeah. West Africa.
Yep. And let me say this too, though. A really, really, my brother's ex-wife, his mom, she's Jewish. Her mom is Jewish. And she taught me, like, well, she's the first person kind of like woke up my taste buds as I'm going into my adulthood. And so she had a lot of influence on me too. But I will give my credit when it comes to seasoning to West Africa all day. Because they taught me. And then when I went to culinary school, I used to be making some of them professors mad because I'd be like, it needs this. And they were like, you don't put that in that. And I'm like, yeah, you do. And when they didn't look, I put it in there and it should be bomb.
That's right. They say seasoning came from the motherland.
Talk about don't wash your meat. Why not?
They say I got rice in my wig. So you know I do, Lonzo, girl. I got rice in my wig. Man, this shit was good. I'm dog. Nah. Holly, you've had my mother's cooking, right?
Yes, and she cooks very well.
My mother cooks, mm-hmm. And you're a chef. Mm-hmm. My mother, see, the way you season food and the way my mother season food different, you professionally season food. Miss Mary Go. So would you say that is a piece when people don't measure food, I mean measure seasoning, mm-hmm. and they season food, would you say that food definitely comes from the soul?
I think so, yeah. Because I don't season everything like that. Like my brine, yeah, that's science. Me coming up with that, that's like long time taking my time to figure that out. So yeah, that's a measuring thing. But when it comes to like regular stuff, like when I make curry goat and oxtail,
I don't like
stuff,
goat either.
You don't like goat? See, you don't like gamey meat. That's what it is. You don't like gamey meat because goat is gamey. It's very, very, very gamey. So you don't like gamey meat. That's all it is. Mm-mm. But I bet you I know something you would love if you had it.
Tell me.
Ostrich. You'd love ostrich.
It's a bird, eh?
It's a bird, but it's all red meat. When they bring it to you, you're going to think you're having some type of
steak.
Filet. Yeah. Right. Right. So it's extremely lean.
So you've had, so you've eaten ostrich. You've actually prepared ostrich.
Mm-hmm.
For who?
I did it in culinary school. Yeah, culinary, I went to the Art Institute. They open you up to a lot of things, you know what I mean? That you didn't really, you wouldn't have, because that's what they're supposed to do. If you want to be a real good chef, you got to be willing to learn how to cook and eat.
So tell us about the art of the preparation of the...
Of what? Ostrich?
Of the cuisine.
Wait, which cuisine? Because there's a whole bunch of cuisines.
The forbidden cuisines.
What's the forbidden cuisine? Coochie and stuff like that?
No, those are eaten. No, those aren't forbidden. You eat those. I'm talking about the forbidden cuisine.
Okay, I must be really, really slow. What is the forbidden cuisine?
That we be thanking, girl, honey, is inside the plates over there at Wong Nim. That's
food.
A gamey meat.
Well,
okay.
I was like, I don't know if this is chicken or what, and I didn't eat it. But I don't believe all of that. But I will say this, you never see cats around them places.
Listen, here's the thing. And that's, I mean, that was a little jokey joke.
Yeah, it wasn't serious.
It was a little jokey joke. However, I had a friend of mine that lived in China.
Oh, they do. You can buy dogs and stuff.
And you can buy it.
Yeah, you can to eat. Yeah.
He told me that it was a delicacy. Mm-hmm. And I was like, girl, why?
Mm-hmm. It is. You can actually buy. They have, and they be alive, running around the little pens, and you can pick what you want. Yeah, it is. It's definitely true. What they saying?
Somebody said, girl.
It's true. It's a delicacy.
My friend told me that. He said he lived in China for almost a year and something. It was like almost 2 years he lived there. And he said he saw it with his eyes. And he said he was so wrecked that they had skinned it. And it was hanging, girl.
That's how when you kill an animal, that's how you have to do it. So they
and it
out.
Was hanging, and it was very much so, girl, honey. They asked, how did he want it prepared? And he was like, Lord. I said, well, how did you have it prepared? He said he didn't. He said he didn't. He couldn't.
Yeah, I wouldn't be able to either, because I love my dog. I love cats more. Okay, I love my dog, but I'm more of a cat person than I am a dog.
Someone in the comment section said they like monkey brains.
I've heard of that. I don't know about Asian people and monkey brains, but I have heard of monkey brains being a delicacy.
Yes, I have heard that too.
Yeah, I'm not eating that. It's too close to a human. We share, 99% of our DNA with apes? I'm not eating that.
Now, listen. If you were scared out there in the Kilimanjaro, bitch, with a knife and some wood and some matches.
You freaking see some monkey brains.
Them monkeys is done.
It's like, I'm sorry.
Bitch, them hoes better motherfucking, them hoes better have their battle armor on, bitch, because they're done. bitch.
Boom.
And don't you get too loud, bitch. Ooh, ooh, ah, ooh. You motherfuckers better get back.
You banana eating
motherfucker. Y'all is full of motherfucking full of potassium, bitch. Bitch, listen, it'll never be a bone density problem ever again. It'll never be. This is the way I look at it, and it might sound fucked up. Mm-hmm. It's gonna sound fucked up. Mm-hmm. Hell, if they'll eat us, bitch, why we can't eat them?
They sure will. They get hungry enough. Anything eat us. Lion, tigers, bears.
Dog.
Right. You right. A dog will tear up a dead body.
Dog will go to work.
Right. Yeah, you right. I don't think that's fucked up, though.
A dog will go clean the work.
I think that's pretty accurate.
Yeah, be over there licking that shit until it's motherfucking moist.
Right. Do you know a dog... Your dog, and this my dog just to me, it was really kind of freaked me out. I had a cut on my arm, and my dog wanted to lick my cut.
Yes.
The dog. Yeah, I was like, what?
The dog wanted to savor the flavors.
That's like a weird thing. But they say that dog saliva, though, is very like.
I don't want none of it on me.
It's very cleaning.
I don't want none of it licking on motherfucking me.
Okay, did I say too much?
No, you ain't saying okay. Shit, because listen, I'm behaving. Because I go real deep in the dog area. They set your ass loose out there if they want to, bitch. Tell me about something, you hungry.
Right.
I'm going for the first thing moving.
The pick and ease.
That bitch get out of the way. Move, bitch. You know?
I'm going to put the pot on.
That macaroni and cheese is good, dog. Like, listen, you said this is three cheeses?
It's four cheeses.
Four cheeses. What are the four cheeses, may I ask? Because I do taste cheddar.
Cheddar is definitely in there.
Hold on. Let me see if I'm a connoisseur of good meats and eats.
It's white and
Is it provolone in here too?
No.
Monster.
No.
It tastes like a pizza. That's why I asked, was it provolone in here?
It's like, I can't really pronounce it, but a cojita. It's a Mexican. that Mexican white cheese.
So this is Mexican white cheese?
Mm-hmm. And I ain't telling no more.
I'm telling you, I taste.
But you do say it tastes mild cheddar for sure, and then you have that white cheddar as well.
But it also tastes a little bit like...
You got that... There's rosemary in it.
I know.
And there's thyme in there as well.
Is it by accident, or you just put it in?
I put it in there. My seasoning that I make, I put it in there.
So you put rosemary and thyme in your macaroni and cheese?
Yeah. You
want to
taste a little bit of it?
I do taste flavors of it.
And thyme is an Italian type of, so you got to get that kind of.
That's why I said it tastes like a pizza.
Yeah, it has garlic in it too. So you're getting that pizza-esque type.
That's why I said it tastes pizza, mm-hmm. pizza-ish. Mm-hmm. But. Sure. The cheese.
I'm going to tell you the other one when you.
When we cut off?
Uh-huh. Yep. That one you're going to be like, dang, I should do. That one you're going to be like, dang. I knew that. This is a real ghetto cheese. That's why it's good. Ghetto cheese.
Oh, bitch. This is good macaroni, girl.
And it heats up so well.
It is so good. And I'm going to be so bagged up and stopped up.
Yeah, we'll constipate the hell out of you.
Yes. And what is it? What's my... there's a cheese that I like. It's one of my favorite cheeses. It's smoked Gouda.
Oh, I love smoked Gouda. I'm going to make you a smoked Gouda mac and cheese. When I tell you, that is so good. I use smoked Gouda and Vermont white cheddar when I make that. It is so
good. Oh, Vermont white cheddar.
Yes, it's so good. Oh, it's so good. And you got to use like really good, like expensive type. Not super expensive, like Cracker Barrel cheeses and stuff like that. It's so good. I'm going to make you a white macaroni.
Now, Holly, I really want... What I want you to make for me, being that I've tasted the way this macaroni and cheese tastes, mm-hmm. really, I would honestly, in all honesty, want you, if before I leave, to go out of town mm-hmm. for Christmas. I would like for you to make me a lasagna.
Oh, yes, for sure. I make a great lasagna. And let me tell you, before I serve it, I like to put it... well. Before I serve it to you, I got to come on like an hour before. I like to put it on top of a hot pot of boiling water and cover it with foil. Oh my God, it just melts. Oh. Oh, it's so good.
Holly, this macaroni and cheese is so good.
But you're
going to
be constipated.
I'm going to be constipated.
Yeah,
I feel it.
Every time I eat it, I get constipated.
But I know a big dick nigga out there that's...
unplug it, right?
Baby, that's been hitting me up right now. My phone been beating over here right now. That'll knock a hole in that motherfucker.
Right now.
And bitch, it'll open the airwaves like a bitch.
I'll just have to eat some collard greens. Because there is no entry back there.
Baby, listen. I know him right now. Knock a hole in the bitch and say, pull all that shit down, bitch. Bitch, you can't motherfucking get... You can't move. I'll make you move. Bitch, there's somebody called a sheriff in this motherfucker.
I can't eat macaroni every day like that.
You want to evict this cheese? I'm the sheriff coming around here, bitch. I'm going to put the notice on the door.
Arrest me.
You know how those eviction notice, and then they'll be waiting on the sheriff.
The sheriff come
through there and put all that shit out. It'll be a lock on the door. The sheriff will pull that lock off. The sheriff coming in and putting all that shit down.
Damn.
That's what I'm gonna start calling them big old them big dick niggas. In 2020, all big dick niggas will be known as the sheriff.
Officer.
All big, if you's a nigga with a big dick out there, bitch, your new nickname is the sheriff. Okay? You're coming in, put all that shit out of there.
You're so stupid.
You're coming in, peel all that shit out of there.
You want something to drink?
Yes. Good, honey. Listen, that's what they gonna be called. If you was a dude out there and you got a big dick, what's up, Jordan? Listen, if you was a nigga living in this America right now, in this America, even in the world, whether you black or white, if you got a big dick in 2020, your new nickname is the sheriff. Because you will come in there and put all that shit out. Anything that's locked up in that motherfucker, you will come put all that shit out. All of it. And you won't give a fuck. Nothing about it. Girl, give me some of that. Oh, I don't want no Red Bull. Holly, what you trying to do? You trying to put this Red Bull in me? Bitch, you... God damn it.
I put big dicks in you, so she
That's right. Somebody put down there, the sheriff is in town. God damn it. Now, y'all know I'm the one said it. So if you see a nigga, walk around talking about they the sheriff, they got they motherfucking got that shit from the real T.S. Madison, bitch, the sheriff. If you No, I don't want no alcohol right now. It's too early in the day, girl. And I don't want no goddamn
it's
alcohol.
It's my birthday, so.
Oh, you want alcohol?
No, I'm not gonna have none until later. You know, I don't act right.
Yeah, well, I want to know this, Holly. Is today your birthday? Is you meeting the sheriff today? Is you meeting the sheriff?
I don't know, girl.
Listen. Nah, I know all niggas out there ain't got big dicks, but they probably know how to put a mother. They probably know how to put that shit out. So if you ain't the sheriff, honey, you possibly could be the lieutenant,
the deputy.
If you know you ain't really got no big dick, and you can still put all that shit out, you probably the deputy. But I'm talking to the big dick motherfucking niggas. I'm talking about to the niggas that's dick as long as my arm. Bitch, you see how my arm disappeared on this screen? You see how my arm, you can see my whole, that bitch disappeared on the screen. I'm talking about a nigga with a big dick who dick disappears off the screen. That's when you know you's a big dick nigga. When you can put your dick on the screen and that motherfucker vanishes. That's when you know you a sheriff. That's when you know. So the dick test in 2020 is if that motherfucker disappear off the screen like this here. And only that's left. You is the sheriff.
Okay, I don't want no sheriff.
You don't want no sheriff?
Hell no.
Because he'll come in there and put all that shit out.
Yeah, I don't want my shop guts.
Listen, the sheriff will come in there and put that shit out from the front door and the back door.
I don't want my guts mash up. Sorry.
Listen, the motherfucking sheriff will come in there and take that bitch out from the front door and the back door.
And I don't need that. I just need the medium. Yeah,
listen. You don't want to get fucked up with the sheriff.
No, I don't.
Hell.
Then your soul gets snatched.
God damn.
Your soul snatched.
No, you see, your soul gets snatched when you, when the sheriff, when you appreciate the sheriff doing that.
Yeah. When you laying down the law.
Listen, when you appreciate the sheriff opening the front door and the back door, taking all that shit out, when you start appreciating him doing that, that's when your soul gone.
Soul gets snatched.
Put it out, sheriff. Take it out. Lay it on the ground, sheriff. Leave it right there on the ground, baby.
That
had
been crazy.
Yeah.
I come too old to be looking.
Wait a minute, that's I got something on the side of my nose. Girl, is it macaroni? Girl, I don't know. Is it macaroni? Bitch, that food was good, Holly.
Good.
And I'm full a little bit.
Good. Well,
but I want to demolish this rosemary chicken, but ain't no more.
But you gonna have more, Oliver? We'll have some.
Damn, Oliver. Oliver trying to get the sheriff to come over there. That's what Oliver doing. Oliver trying to get the sheriff to come open the back door and the front door. Well, shit, he ain't got but a back door. That's all he got. Some
I got
of
a front door.
Listen, you got a front door. See, some of us ain't got nothing but a back door, bitch. And there's a lot of sheriffs out there. That's the door they hit, they tap on first.
But I don't want a sheriff.
Girl, get you a sheriff that knows how to unlock both of them motherfuckers. God damn it.
Sheriff.
You don't want no sheriff?
I'd be looking, come up here looking crazy. You'd be like, Holly, what's wrong? Huh? You know, you'd be like, did your soul get snatched? They snatched it.
Listen, ain't no man out there finna snatch my soul. Now, he may
now,
open the door.
Good dick soul snatching, Madison. Come on now.
Listen, he may open the door. He may open the back door and come on in there and pull some shit out there. But, bitch, he ain't finna snatch my soul.
Soul snatching.
I'm going to tell you why I ain't finna let no nigga snatch my soul. Because my mind is grounded.
Oh, of course.
Mind's so grounded, bitch. Because I know about them soul snatchers.
Yeah.
Because it took a while for me to get. I lost my soul twice.
Yeah, I've been there. And I don't want that ever again.
And you know the way of losing your soul.
Right.
With them niggas. Right. With them soul snatchers.
I don't want no soul snatchers.
You know the way. Them bitches prey on the weak. They like the Cartwrights. They prey on the weak mind. And you know, dick will break your mind cycle down. A sheriff will knock your mind. He'll be coming in the back door or the front door, taking all that shit down. But he hit that attic.
Yeah.
Get up there in that top half of the house.
Mm-hmm. That's a good word for it, the attic.
The attic.
Like that.
He get up there in that motherfucking attic, honey.
Yeah, like
your soul is definitely on the way out.
Yeah,
that. Ladies, do not let them men in 2020 snatch your motherfucking soul. Don't do that. It ain't worth it, Miss Seeley. Miss Seeley, it ain't worth it. It ain't worth it, Miss Seeley. All your life you have to fight. It ain't worth it letting Mr. come through there and snatch your soul like that. Ba-sha-ta-da-bo-sha. Keep your soul and spirit rooted in the Lord. Don't let him come snatch your soul, honey. Keep the let the Lord have your soul. Don't let these niggas take your soul with them, because they'll take your soul right with them.
Right. Open another bitch house.
No, listen, he got that bitch soul too.
Right, right. You got a bag full of souls.
He got a bag full of souls. R. Kelly was a soul snatcher.
And you got a stomach full of mashup.
His stomach full of mashup. R. Kelly was a soul snatcher.
He had to be. For many women to fall for that.
He snatched them girls' souls.
Yeah, he had to. He had to be.
Now, I don't know if he was a... Wait a minute. Was he a sheriff?
I didn't really see the video like that.
I don't know if he really was a sheriff. And see, back then when I was young, I used to think big dicks meant something else. Well, you know, I used to, listen, until I started really getting out here in this world, experiencing dicks. Mm-hmm. Experiencing mm-hmm. dicks.
Spurts.
Mm-hmm. And I know that dicks come in more sizes than just two or three. I done seen two or three sizes, and then I done seen those sizes over there.
Right. Oh, that's them.
Them over there.
With the arm out
there? Yeah.
Okay. I've only seen one of them.
That's the ones over there?
Yeah.
Yeah.
I mash up my stomach.
Mash up your stomach?
Mash up my stomach.
Them ones over there. Mm-hmm. And ladies and some of you gentlemen out there understand what I'm talking about. Mm-hmm. You done seen maybe three or four size dicks, and then you done seen them ones over there.
Yeah. I only seen one of them over there. I mash up my stomach.
Them ones over there, you be like, they be tempting you, because those are they call me automatic soul snatchers.
That was the one that had me completely fucked up.
They automatically soul
snatchers. That's the one that had me completely fucked up.
They don't even get in your mind. They just come in your door. They automatically snatch your soul, because they done press that button, and you like, wait a minute. Because you don't really want to feel that feeling, and then you really do. And then it be, I'm talking about the soul snatcher. Bitch, that's a soul. Listen, those are soul snatchers. He beyond the sheriff. He beyond the sheriff. The sheriff can snatch your soul when he get in that attic. But it's those automatic ones that so they come in the door soul snatcher.
Grim Reaper, that pussy.
Them motherfuckers come in the door soul snatchers. They walk in, they snatching your soul. Them listen, everyone. A motherfucker take a dick out and lay that bitch. I had a dude before pull his dick out like this when I was in 2006. How old I was back then? When was 2006? 13 years ago.
I graduated college in 2004, and I was
25. And as it's 2006.
I was 27, you were 26.
I had a motherfucker. You know, what's the computer called? I had a PC, a personal computer.
Mac?
Not a Mac. A PC. PC. Before Mac was doing
Dell.
It was a Dell, okay. But it was a big Dell. Mm-hmm. That motherfucking boy came there and laid his dick from one end of my computer across the other one. Let's see how my laptop over there open. That dick laid from the open of that one end of the laptop to the other. I was like, oh my god, that was an automatic soul snatch.
I wasn't having sex with him.
Well,
I'm sorry.
I just couldn't believe it. I couldn't believe it. It laid from that side of the computer, right mm-hmm. that end, to the other end of the computer. Just laid the bitch over there.
That's a devil dick.
Soul snatcher.
Yeah.
Only person supposed to have your soul is the Lord.
That's it. Jesus.
Until he send it somewhere.
Jesus. Back in my pearls.
Bitch.
What should I do?
That dick laid from one side of the computer. It went over the laptop keyboard. I was like, girl, what the fuck is going on in there? And it was, the response was very.
What is it? So you know he about to snatch your whole life.
Yeah, I told him, sir, I have an anus. You in the wrong place. I have an anus. A-N-U-S. Not a vagina.
But not even my vagina can take that.
Yes, they can.
Vaginas are different, too, because some of us are long, some of us are short. You know, it depends. Okay, I'm gonna shut up.
You got a long vagina or a short vagina? You from the islands. I know you got a long vagina.
I have a short torso.
Remember you from leg? The islands. I know you got them
my
island girls.
Not up here.
Baby, them island girls got some long ass vaginas.
I
know about y'all island girls.
I got a short torso.
I know about y'all island girls. Now
I
listen.
I'm going to get my short.
Uh-huh.
So I'm not going to have no long.
Yeah.
A short.
Listen.
My upper body is made for a short woman, and my lower body is made for a tall person.
But listen now. I want you to hear me, Holly.
Yeah.
Okay? Listen closely.
Yes.
It's some women out there that are soul snatchers, too.
Hell yeah. I know that.
It's some women.
I think I'm one of them. Let me tell you why.
It's some women sheriffs too.
Let me tell you why. Why I think I am. Motherfucker pouring paint on my car, breaking into my shit. I gotta move and hide and shit.
But see, women can't be the sheriff because they ain't got the shit. They ain't got the key to get in the back door or the front door. They can't be that. So women can't never be the sheriff. Women maybe, but that's still women can't never be the sheriff. It ain't the same. But a woman, a soul snatcher could be a woman and a man.
Yeah.
But an automatic soul snatcher. Like,
I had a friend tell me one time they was watching a flick. Uh-huh. Man, that's old school.
A flick, yeah. Come on, tell me the real flick.
And she said the lady sat down on top of the man. She didn't move her body. That's them Kegel that, you know, whatever. And he just burst out of sweat. All she did was contract that thing. She had control of it. And that's all she did. She didn't move her body. She ain't, just sat on top of it and let her muscle do it. And she said he just burst out of sweat.
If he burst out of sweat, did he burst out of semen?
He must have had. But I had never heard about that before until someone explained to me about Kegel. It was a long time ago. You know, somebody explained to me that.
Oh, they say, okay, they say females are deputies. No, females are lieutenants.
Right.
Because, see, deputies still got dick. Deputy dick. So, because some of you niggas out there that's deputy dick. And you other motherfuckers is the sheriff. You big dick niggas is the sheriff. And
the
then
chief.
You... The chief is the soul snatcher.
Soul snatcher, okay.
They the chiefs. Those are the ones that you can't even classify them as a big dick nigga. They just dim over there.
Right. Right. Dim over there. Come through knocking shit off your dresser.
Them over there. They come the motherfucker. They lay their dick across your computer screen. And the goddamn keyboard vanish. The keyboard, that dick went over that shit like that, Holly. And it was still pelvis there.
Was
and
it
bald.
Hard?
Yes. Okay. I was like, girl, what is it? I was like, sir,
I guess it have to be hard. Because if it wasn't hard, it was like that. God damn.
No, I done seen some soggy dick do that, too.
What?
I ain't with all that stuff. Even though I'm a connoisseur, I do like, if a dick be too big,
mm-hmm.
I just like to suck it.
Yeah, I don't want that old
dick. I don't be wanting all that stuff in me, bitch. I ain't got time for all that.
Yeah.
I just, right. If it's too, if it's a soul snatcher.
Mm-hmm.
I ain't gonna tell you no lie like that. I didn't attempt.
Mm-hmm.
Because there was so much curiosity in there. Like, I wanna know how that feels.
That's why it's a soul snatcher.
Yes, because it starts getting your. It tempts you. It be sitting over there tempting you.
Tempted to touch.
Hey. It be tempting you. It be like, I don't wanna know what it. I wanna know what that feel like.
Yeah, now your soul gets
snatched. Then your soul be gone. Because if you lay in that position and you lay flat and then let that bitch be strong and get on you, it's in there like ragu.
It took years for me to get over that soul snatcher.
It's in there like ragu, honey. And it go in there. But see, though, but what the gag is, what be really going on is that those soul snatchers get their soul snatched too.
They do.
Because they don't, yes, because they do. It ain't many that's going to let them go in there.
Right.
And then when they do go in there and they do two or three pumps and next thing you know, honey, they done exploded.
Right.
They try to figure out what the hell done happened. I hate to say this, and this going to sound real racist, but I'm just going to keep it 2000. Them goddamn Chinese women, them little Kims.
Really?
Them little Ching Chong girls.
Really?
Them, you ain't never watched them porno tape, them Ching Chong. Them Ching Chong. Baby,
yeah, I have seen one.
Baby,
yeah.
Listen, them Ching Chong girls will come through there. Listen, we be over there complaining about them anaconda. They will, that bitch, they will always be like, hiya,
right.
Me. Moo goo goo.
They mold different too.
Them bitches be like, moo goo got pumped. And it go right down on the bitch.
Moo goo
got pumped. They be like, bitch! And it go in their ass.
Really?
Yeah, I gotta show you some porn. Them motherfuckers.
Porn like
them bitches will be like, moo goo got pun. Whoop.
And I don't watch porn like
and
that.
And that motherfucker, those soul snatchers dicks disappear. Vanish.
Maybe that's why they like them so much.
Bitch, and them bitches be 94 pounds.
Right, they little.
Well, that's something I never know. This all you hear. Whoop. And the original soul snatcher is really gone. His mind gone. It's in his place. That's why them niggas be in them songs rapping about them bitches.
Yeah.
I like my women foreign. Yes, bitch.
They do.
Cause them niggas, cause them peoples over there in their country, they ain't horse hang like that.
Well, you know, I heard Arab men and Jewish men have the biggest.
Girl, listen. I have had an Arab man. It was a piece of candy, but ain't nothing hung like no black nigga.
Really?
Hell no.
I've dated Jewish, but I've never been with a Jewish.
I've had all nationalities, Holly. I used to be a hooker.
Oh, okay.
I don't make that no secret.
That is true.
I done traveled this country when I was doing that. I've traveled, bitch. New York got everything you want, bitch. If you're Irish, they got it. If you're Cuban, they got it. If you're Puerto Rican, they got it. If you're motherfucking Native American, they got it. Bitch, if you're Chinese, they got it. If you're Japanese, they got it. If you're Vietnamese, they got it. Bitch, whatever you want in New York City, they got it.
They got it.
And I used to go there, bitch, at least twice out the year and come home with at least 10 racks.
Got some good pussy.
At least I got good everything.
Okay.
Right. Definitely good communication skills.
Okay.
Nigga, you can't touch me unless you done ran me that. And I'm gonna need a deposit for that before you arrive.
Okay.
You can't I don't give a fuck how many bitches you done fucked and how many souls you done snatched and how many motherfucking hoes you can get for 40.
Right.
Bitch, you can't touch me.
Right.
And I'm fat. See, my mind, my skill set was trained when I used to walk them sidewalks back in the day. Mm-hmm. When I used to see all the pretty bitches down the street. Mm-hmm. And them bitches used to be always struggling on their bills. Mm-hmm. And I wasn't, because I was always the ugly one.
Mm. But you're not ugly.
No, I'm not ugly, I know, but you know, I didn't look like them.
Oh.
So, bitch, you know, and they would be moving every other month. Mm-hmm. New cell phone number with a new company under a new name.
Mm-hmm.
Bitch, and I was down in the same tradition, in my same shit, getting my money. So that's why a bitch asked me, T.S. Madison, why your confidence is high as it is? I said, and my confidence is high because I don't, what y'all consider bad bitches, I don't walk circles all around them. Mm-hmm. Fine, pretty, this, walk circles all around them.
Mm-hmm.
How is it that we in the same industry and I'm ugly, but you doing worse than me?
First of all, Maddie is not ugly.
But I'm just saying.
Yeah.
That what they used to be. How is it?
Well, you know what they say about me, right?
What?
They call me Flat Bum Holly.
Flat Bum?
Flat Bum ain't got a bum.
Listen, that's what I want to know. How is it that we in the same industry, and any of you whores out there, that doubt yourself, and you in the same industry, I want to give y'all a piece of advice that's going to step your confidence level up. So put your ear to the street so that you can understand.
Boy, this shit too.
If you in the same industry with a bitch that's supposed to be better than you and you know that bitch struggling and you not, you's a bad motherfucker.
Yes, you are.
And don't you never ever doubt yourself next to damn motherfucker that everybody's make bigger than you, better than you, and this and the other, and they going through problems, bitch. Or they going through this and you ain't got them saying you don't have them issues, bitch, because you get your money. That goes for MUAs, hairdressers. Bitch, you might see them hoes over there with 100 clients, bitch, and they ain't went nowhere, bitch. And you probably got 15 clients and you done opened up shops all over the motherfucking nation, bitch. Yeah. Don't see no bitch. I want you to understand this. Don't you see no bitch? Because T.S. Madison don't see no bitch walking. I don't give a fuck how pretty that bitch is, how fine that bitch is, how much skinnier and smaller that motherfucking hoe is to me, how much prettier that bitch skin is than mine. Bitch, me and that hoe ain't the same person. So therefore, bitch, my mind is intact. And that's why when I was in that hoeing business, I used to tell them niggas, I don't give a fuck who you gave $200 to. Bitch, I want five.
Right.
I don't give a fuck who you gave $75. Yes.
My price is not really low.
This why you bitches got to stand firm. I'm talking to all my bitches out there. Y'all bitches got to stand firm on who you are. When you know who you are, bitch, you are unshakable. Bitch, can't no hoe shake me. I see when people be talking all that fuck shit about, can't no bitch shake me. Nail bitch shake me. I ain't intimidated by nail hoe. And I want y'all to know that. So don't compare me to nail hoe. Don't motherfucking say I should be doing, because I don't see nail living bitch. Not one. And you shouldn't see nail one of them motherfuckers either.
That's some good advice.
You shouldn't.
That's some good advice.
A bitch asked me, how is your confidence level so high, Madison? I used to work next to bad bitches, and I was always labeled the ugly one. And I used to see every month them bad bitches had to move. Because they couldn't get keep their rent motherfucking paid. Bitch, my shit was on time, and we was in the same industry. Right. How we in the same industry, and I'm ugly, and you doing bad, and I ain't? Some ain't together. Something ain't together. You can have all the beauty in the motherfucking world, but bitch, your business ain't together. You can have all the body in the motherfucking planet, bitch, but your shit ain't together upstairs. So, bitch, don't you sit around here on God's green earth, bitch, and see now, ho. You are given the same tools that bitch was given.
Right. The attic dusty.
Holly, you ain't the only one cooking.
No.
But you know how to cook, right?
Right.
Do you see a next bitch cooking? Miss Mary cooks down. Yes, do you? You don't see Miss Mary. And Miss Mary don't see you either. Miss Mary say, well, taste that, say, oh, this good. That's your macaroni. And this hers. Mm-hmm. When you get in your head that you are who you are and that bitch is who that bitch is, and run your business. Mm-hmm. I don't give a fuck about what the next bitch doing. I don't care. I don't care what the next bitch doing because I don't see the next bitch. I can congratulate the next bitch and keep moving.
Right.
I ain't intimidated about her.
Right.
Ever. Never have been. Never will be. And I'm telling y'all, y'all might look down on me because I walk them streets and all that shit. That shit taught me so many valuable lessons.
That's what I'm saying. Everybody has experiences. And what I hate is people, they judge people. Because I've been through some horrible shit.
Mm.
I'm not going to say, you know, here, but, you know, I've been through some, and I had to survive it. I had family members turn against me, treat me terrible. Just turn on me. And, you know.
I love you too, baby. Morgan.
Those experiences build character, and they show you who your real people are.
Right.
You know what I mean? And then, and I think these folks that know me are shocked at where I am right now.
Sister, let me tell you something.
And I love it.
You got to be confident in who you is. You got to be confident in what you do. You don't think I see them hoes writing up under my, calling me fat and all this stuff. And I'd be like, don't you worry about it, bitch. Because right. Believe you me, I know somebody like it.
Right.
And just because y'all ain't never seen me out no niggas like the rest of them hoes have. Mm-hmm. Just because you ain't seen me out no celebrity niggas, don't you dare. In this world, think that ain't now one of them lusted after me because quiet as it's kept, bitch. I was a sex symbol, bitch, before you girls even knew who I was. And 9 out of 10 times, bitch, any of you transsexual bitches out there that's living, 9 out of 10 times you have met a nigga that done told you that the first bitch that they saw ever fucking a nigga that they wanted to have sex with a transsexual was me, bitch. Was me. The bitch that y'all hoes call fat and unattractive and tired and this and the other, it was me, bitch, that was motherfucking that got you the nigga that you got right now, bitch. So don't even fuck off and think that you can say no disrespectful shit to me because I don't even see you. You don't hurt my feelings, motherfuckers. I wanted to say that before the time ended.
That's okay.
Anyway.
I'm about to head out because I got
Holly about to leave. Happy birthday, y'all. Tell Holly happy birthday. Follow her on Phenomenal Food Catering and stuff like that, bitch. And I love y'all.
We'll be back probably.
And I'll see y'all tonight. Make sure y'all tune in tonight to the show, bitch. Everybody shot, tadabosha. I'll see y'all later on. I love you. I love all of y'all. Bye.
Oh, that was fun. I love that.